Hi, Michele.
Hi, Liz. How are you?
Good, thank you. Michele, you cover the global oil industry for Goldman Sachs Research. So we wanted to talk to you about the emergency meeting that OPEC has called this week among the world's largest oil producers, the so-called OPEC Plus group, who are confronting a huge global imbalance in supply and demand of oil that's reached near crisis proportions. You've written extensively about this. Can you set the scene for us?
Liz, as you lay out, these are extraordinary times. We have never seen a decline in demand similar to what we're facing at the moment, around 20 million barrels per day in April. And as such, it's normal that the world's largest producer, which is OPEC, would adjust its supply in order to avoid producing oil that effectively the market cannot utilize at this point in time. So we do expect that OPEC will come to an agreement over reducing oil supplies, probably around the 10 million barrels per day. And this will be important to reduce the rapid buildup we're starting to see in global oil inventories. It may not be enough to rebalance the market given the extraordinary demand shock, but we do believe that it could substantially help to rebalance the market in the long term and set the industry back on a more sustainable path of higher returns and higher oil prices.
And beyond OPEC's actions, what strategy do you expect the major oil producers to take from here?
We believe the global oil producers, we need to focus on three key things here. The first one is resilience, because these are difficult times, and assuring strong balance sheet, strong liquidity, and strong cash flow management will be very important. But they've navigated this over the last century, and I think they will be able to navigate this crisis as well. Secondly, I think they should focus on their CapEx budgets and really think thoroughly through which investments to move forward at these difficult junctures and which ones to delay. And we think a lot of investment will be delayed, both in oil and gas, potentially creating a much more interesting supply picture in the longer term. And then thirdly, I think they should continue to concentrate strongly on their decarbonization efforts. Although it's not today's most pressing concern, climate change remains absolutely top of mind. And the actions that the oil companies can take in decarbonizing their businesses, advancing their renewables and decarbonization efforts will be extremely important. And I think they should continue on that path despite the lower energy prices.
But won't the collapse in oil prices make it more difficult for oil companies to focus on decarbonization and climate change?
It will make it without doubt more difficult in the near term. But this is what I think will really distinguish the companies that will emerge stronger from this downturn. In the past, recessions tended to take the attention away from long-term problems like climate change. But I think this time around will be different. I think investors will remain focused on climate change. And this will achieve two purposes. One, restricting the investments in traditional oil and gas, which will create a better supply environment in the long term for oil and gas prices. And two, continue to foster investment in R&D and the new technologies for decarbonization, which ultimately can also foster more job creation, more investment, and the better and faster recovery out of this downturn.
Thanks, Michele.
Thank you, Liz, for the discussion and all the best.